You know, I don't know whether you know it. I launched America's Lawyer with Russian television, and that is that's picked up.
It's a weekly show, right?
A weekly show, yeah.
Right. Yeah.
And it's you know what I love about it, Bill, is being able.
We call it RT.
RT. Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. God forbid we should talk about the Russians. My God, the DNC goes crazy, don't they? But at any rate, the beauty of the program is, as you know, in the past I've been a contributor, as you have, to MSNBC and CNN various organizations, and I always found it very difficult to tell stories where the advertisers wouldn't let you tell the story. I recall one situation. Matter of fact, I'm sitting here watching Joe Scarborough on one of the my former law partner. Yeah, and. And so Joe and I were doing a story on a type of wood that was arsenic laced, and so I reported the story on MSNBC, and got a call the next day saying we've got to apologize. This is wrong. We shouldn't have done it. Well, the facts were completely correct. There was nothing that was reported where the facts were wrong. I'm pretty clear about when I do a story like that. And I said, no, I'm not going to report. I'm not going to apologize. I'm not going to do anything. It's a good story. And so the point is, when you have advertisers that put pressure on a corporate media entity, whether it's NBC, CBS, you know, they have to call that person on the 50th floor and they have to say, can we do this story? That's no longer journalism. What you're doing here is journalism. These are public airways. And so I looked for the place that I could go and tell stories about pharmaceutical companies that were killing people with dangerous pharmaceuticals or polluters that were destroying waterways and airways. And it happened to be RT. RT America said, yeah, do these shows. And not one time has anybody told me or Ed Schultz or Larry King or any of the people on that network what we can and can't say. I was horrified when I saw these hearings last week where you had these numbnuts, attacking RT America as if it's some kind of Russian propaganda entity.
What if you wanted to do a story that was critical of Vladimir Putin and the Kremlin?
I've done it. Okay? Let me just be clear. I've done it. And I didn't get a call from any producer or any executive saying I had to go on the air and apologize. And see, so what's happened here, and it's just the ugliest thing, the DNC got their butt kicked, okay? DNC, by way of John Podesta, who is a total moron, lost an election against somebody that it's impossible to lose against.
Yeah, one of the most beatable candidates.
I point out, he was chair of the Clinton campaign. He was not chair of the DNC.
But he's still a moron, okay? And so and so is his brother, okay? So all of a sudden they lose the campaign. They have to have something that they can say about how do you explain it? Well, you know, first the Barney Bros did it, and then, you know, Susan Sarandon did it, and Bernie did it, and then the Russians did it. And now it's kind of spun out to where the weapons industry has gotten involved in it, and they want a Cold War with Russia. That's what this is all about.